نتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الكلام كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أوصيكم بتقوى الله عز وجل، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل، فقد فاز المتقون. وأذكركم ونفسي بقول الله تبارك وتعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنذر نفس ما قدمت لغد، واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. Dear Muslims, all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who gave his will to all human society from the past to the last to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَقَدْ وَصَّيْنَا الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَإِيَّاكُمْ أَنِ اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. This is the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his order to all mankind, to observe your duties towards him and think of the day when we will meet him and he will ask us and we have to answer. The will of Ali bin Abi Talib, karamallahu wajha, when he was sick, few weeks before he was killed as a shaheed, and his big son, Al-Hasan, radiallahu anhuma, said to him, "Oh, our father, give us your will. I'm afraid that you may die tonight." And Ali bin Abi Talib, karam Allah wajahu, said to him, "Wallahi, lan amut al-layla, walan amut min hadha al-marad." He said to his son, "I swear by Allah, I will not die tonight. And I will not die from this sickness, because I heard the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam telling me that you will not die until your blood wet your beard." And he believed in that. It means he's going to be killed. It is part of the indication what the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam told his sahaba, what may happen one day. Part of the ghaib that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it open to them. عَالِمُ الْغَيْبِ فَلَا يُظْهِرُ عَلَىٰ غَيْبِهِ أَحَدًا إِلَّا مَنْ ارْتَدَى مِنْ رَسُولٍ. He is the only one who knows the unseen and the future. No one except Allah. And only when he will make it open and inform some of the prophets. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam indicated to Ali what may happen to him one day. And truly we know how he died. As usual, whose voice used to encourage people to wake up and pray subuh? When Ali bin Abi Talib used to knock at the people's door saying the salat of subuh, and his words used to touch their heart, and they leave and they go to the masjid. While he was doing that, Ashqaha, the most miserable one, Abu Lu'lu'a, he was hiding his sword underneath of him, and he was sleeping on his stomach. And Ali bin Abi Talib woke him up and said to him, "Do not sleep like this. The people of Jahannam sleep like that. That style of sleeping, sleeping on your stomach." But this man, he was prepared. He planned to kill Ali bin Abi Talib. And he hit him with the sword on his forehead. And Ali bin Abi Talib, karamallahu wajahu, said, "Hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakil." And he was taken home. And his son said to him, "What is your will?" And then he said, "Time, now this is the time of the will. My will to tell you, Allah, Allah, la taqtulu qatili. Don't kill the one who killed me. And my will to you is the will of Ibrahim alayhi salam and Yaqub alayhi salam to their children. ووصى بها إبراهيم بنيه ويعقوب يا بني إن الله اصطفى لكم الدين فلا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. This is the will of Ali bin Abi Talib to his children. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen this deen for you. Make sure you don't die unless you are on Islam. Make sure that you don't die unless you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is the will of Ali bin Abi Talib, the same will of Imam Ibn Sirin when he was telling his children the same thing. We said goodbye to the month of Rabi'ul Awwal, but we will never say goodbye to the birth of the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam, because his birth is our life. And as long as we're still alive, he will be a prophet always in our life, and we will follow his sunnah. And when we read about him, we don't need it as a history, because history is something that happened and it's gone. But with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he never go out of our life. So we read about him as a seerah, a way of life that we need to adapt. History is something like one of the authors, James Cohen, and he wrote a book saying that lies my teacher told me. He's bringing to the mind of the world how the history has been fabricated. And this has been taught to the students of the high school, a wrong history. And why they do that? So that the generation will never really know what really happened. They will only know what they need to be informed. But this is one of the loyal teachers. He used to speak things out. This is wrong. This is wrong. And part of what he said about history is furious debate informed by evidence and reason. But with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, we call that a seerah. And that will never become a history that it happened and it's gone. It is a way of life that will be with us until we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the month of Rabi'ul Awwal is gone. And we go back to ourselves, as we say a few times, the self-conversation is the most important talk we can have in our life, to talk to ourselves. And ask ourselves, where do we stand concerning the life and the teaching of the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam? Especially when we come across a man like that, Rabi'ul Awwal, a man which we have not been told to do anything special in that month more than any other month of the year. We have not been told, and we know that any teaching like that, it must be divine. To make a man special, like the month of Ramadan, it is divine teaching that it has to be special in our life. And the one to explain this is the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. He went through Rabi'ul Awwal, Rabi'ul Thani, Rajab, Sha'ban, and all the rest of the month, and he told us which man to observe and do a specific thing. But with Rabi'ul Awwal, just to remind ourselves how much knowledge I have about the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, and what did that knowledge do to my life as a man. Did his word make a change in the way I dress, in the way I talk, in the way I earn as a woman? Did his word make a change in the way I dress, in the way I talk and behave, and in the way I earn? If it does not, it means we are still dead people. The way Abu Lahab was dead, and the way Abu Jahl was dead, because they did not benefit from the life and from the teaching of the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. So nothing to do with the man, but to do with our life. How did we decide to live? In another way, ذِكْرَيَاتُنَا مَعَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. Our memoir, our memories or remembrance and collections with the life and the teaching of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And we want to listen to one of those people who told us examples of moments he spent and felt towards the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And that is Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu, when he used to say, I have 3 days in my life that I will never forget and I cannot forget. And why he said that? Because what we remember, that is our life. The way one teacher was telling his children, you may leave this class and you may think that you have grown, but you will never grow in my mind. I still look at you from like the day when I saw you walking into the primary school as a kid. And that's how you will remain in my mind. And then he said to them, Antum ba'du dhikrayati wa dhikrayatu hiya al-haya. You are part of my memories in my life. And what we remember, that is our life. If we remember the good things, we have good life. And that's what Islam told us. Let go the problem that you have been through. Even when the closest person from your family pass away, feel it, but no more than 3 days. Let it go, because more will come to test you, to see you mean it when you say, I am a believer or not. Alif lam mim. Ahasib al-nasu an yutraku an yaqulu amanna wa hum la yuftanun. Do people think that we will let them say we believe without a test? فَلَا يَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَا يَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. Through the test, we will prove that we are lying or we are truthful believers, through the test. And that is for us. Otherwise, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows. But the test is to prove who we are by our own self. So if we fail, we blame ourselves. So Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu used to say that there are 3 days I will never forget in my life. The day number one, Yawma Qadim al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam al-Madina. It is the day when the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam came to Medina. And then Anas bin Malik said, فَوَاللَّهِ مَا ظَنَنْتُ أَنَّ أَحَدًا يَبْكِي مِنْ شِدَّةِ الْفَرَحِ حَتَّى رَأَيْتُ الْأَنْصَارَ يَبْكُونَ مِنْ شِدَّةِ فَرَحِهِمْ بِقُدُومِ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. I could not believe that. I didn't think that somebody will cry due to their extreme happiness until I saw the Ansar, the people who were ready to stand up and welcome and accept the messenger who was rejected by his own people from Mecca. It is the Ansar, the second team of Islam, the two team who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was happy with and accepted. لَقَدْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنِ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ الَّذِينَ تَبَعُوهُ فِي سَاعَةِ الْعُسْرَةِ. Both of these teams has been accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they were in tears due to their happiness. A man came into our life when we were waiting for him, when we really wanted him. They lived in darkness enough, and here is the light. And that is the thing that made them cry so hard due to their happiness. And we all need this type of people to come into our life, because if we find out who are the people who are participating in the making of my life, you may see some of them, they may be ruining your life for you. They may be taking you away from the teaching of Islam. They may be making you blind. But we need the people who will help us to live and lead a pure, good, fruitful life. Life that we will never die again with it. And that is the life with the Iman. Our man kana maitan fa'ahyaynahu waja'alna lahu nuran yamshi bihi kama mathaluhu fi dhulumati laysa bi kharijin minha. Are they alive? Someone who used to be dead because they didn't have Islam in their life. And then the nur came into their life and they accept Islam. Now they are alive. Are they equal to those who are still dead? They are not. And in the absence of Islam in my life, then I'm a dead person. And the cloth I'm using is nothing but a coffin already, white clothes to bury me with. And the house I'm living in is my grave already. I may call it palace, or the only part in this world that belongs to me. And I can shape it the way I want, but it is not, it is a grave, if only I know. So Anas bin Malik, radiallahu anhu, explained that the people of Medina were so happy, and he can never forget that day. And the second day is when his mother brought him, gave him shower and perfumed him and took him to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And then she said, Ya Rasulallah, hada Anas, yahdumuka ya Rasulallah, ud'u lahu. O Messenger of Allah, this is the best I can give to you as I come to Medina. It is her labor, her heart. This is the best I have to offer to you. I have nothing to give to you, O Messenger of Allah, after following you, but my son. He is yours and he will serve you for the rest of his life. Please pray for him. That's what she wanted. And we all need this meeting in our life. When our sons, our daughters meet somebody who will help them and hold their hand. Best teachers who will not only have the relation between them and the students, not only in the class, even in their outside life. To impact their life to the extent that wherever they go, they will remember my teacher who taught me this and that, who helped me, through whom I see this world, through whom I came to know more about my deen. These are the people, call them the murabbi. Not only teachers, everybody can teach, but people who really bring education and tarbiyah into a child's life, they are in numbers. And of course, the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, he is the murabbi of those people who educated others. And he is the master of education, we can say. And this is what the mothers wish. The best for our children, please pray for him. And she heard the prayer. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam making the dua for this young boy. Allahumma akthir malahu wa waladahu wa barik lahu fima a'tayta. Oh Allah, give him a lot of wealth and give him many children. And this is the joy of life for any human being. People are struggling to the extreme that sometimes they deny Allah and say yes to the money. They really love it. زُيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ حُبُّ الشَّهَوَاتِ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ وَالْبَنِينِ وَالْقَنَاطِيرِ الْمُقَنْطَرَةِ مِنَ الذَّهَبِ وَالْفِدَّةِ وَالْخَيْلِ الْمُسَوَّمَةِ وَالْأَنْعَامِ وَالْحَرْثِ ذَلِكَ مَتَاعُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. It is not crime to love all of these things. But the crime is when we start to worship that and put that in our heart and take the love of Allah out of our heart. Then children will become a curse. Money will become a curse and everything else because it took me away from my God, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he prayed for him to have a lot of money. And as you know that many people go to paradise through their money. They didn't have knowledge to teach or any other thing to offer to Islam. But they say to Allah, I will come to you through my money, inshallah. By earning it in the right way and spending it on the right way. So Anas was one of the people who Allah gave that wealth as a path to paradise. And also pray for him to have so many children, and he had. And what is beautiful more than when you see your kids, all of them. And when you die, you will not worry because all of them say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. And you see them praying 5 times a day and running away from immoral things and reminding the parents that we have to stick together to make sure that we meet again in paradise. This type of children is useful. Otherwise, innama amwalukum wa awladukum fitna. It is not good for us to have them if we don't really keep them on the right path. But sometimes what happens, they choose not to be on the right path. And then parents' duty is only stay in their life and keep advising them and making da'wah to them the way we are to do to everybody else. But remember that we cannot give them the hidayah. But we do our duty as parents. They will grow and go into life in whatever way they want. But you have done your job. As long as they have seen you, good example, and you taught, when they grow up, they have their own file with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You still pray for them that he died. But the result will be in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Anas bin Malik's farm, can you imagine? It used to have the harvest twice a year, knowing that palm trees only have it once a year. But for Anas bin Malik, it was twice. The dua of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And the maghfirah, of course, on the judgment day. So this is the second day that the best days of his life. And the last one, he says that the day Yawma Faraq al Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa da'ahu. Anas bin Malik said, the day we have been separated physically from the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam, when he said, Sallayna al-dhuhr yawm al-khamis. فكشف صلى الله عليه وسلم ستار غرفته فنظرنا إلى وجهه كأنه ورقة مصحف. On Thursday when we prayed Dhuhr, and the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, due to his sickness, he cannot move anymore, so he was staying home. But he moved the curtain away from his room, the humble curtain, and the Sahaba saw his face, and Allah said, and his face looked like one page from the Quran, Zanun. And then he said, I never seen his face after that until today. Anas bin Malik. And he tried to say, this was the worst day in my life. The day that this thing happened, it means the death of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Of course, they wanted to be with him forever, but the Holy Quran said, وَمَا جَعَلْنَا لِبَشَرٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ الْخُلْدًا أَفَإِن مِتَّ فَهُمُ الْخَالِدُونَ. Eternity was never been written for any human being in the past. The same thing will apply to you. إِنَّكَ مَيِّتٌ وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتُونَ. You will die just like anybody else. And they all should learn, if this dunya world staying in it, and it's good for anybody, it should be the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. But he has gone, and we have to go, and we want to be behind him in this dunya and also in the hereafter. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this type of remembrance to tell us truly, we heard about him. What did I get from his fruit and all his teaching to come into my life with the departure of the Manzah for the Awwal? Am I alive or dead person? So the birth of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam truly is the birth for us, only if we follow his sunnah, and we can do that. We have the chance to do so. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put value of him in our heart. Many people, they knew him and they wrote about him. And they joined him after a lot of criticism, but they used to criticize because they want to know the truth. And one of those people was Amr ibn al-As, which has another thing to talk about. With his days with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and Umar bin Khattab and all the Sahaba, they had a history. But that has gone, and then they had Sirah, and that will never go. And Sirah will never disappear because we are told to follow that. The way they live their life, because it is on the line that link with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and to all the prophets. وَإِنَّ هَذِهِ أُمَّتُكُمْ أُمَّةً وَاحِدًا وَأَنَا رَبُّكُمْ فَاعْبُدُونَ. So the real family tree for every Muslim is when we follow the sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Not to gather for him and praise him. The real praise is to really follow silently what he told us to do in his life. And that is the real love to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Hakim. Waja'alana wa iyaakum min al-ladhina istami'una al-qawla fattabi'una ahsana. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Fastaghfiruhu innahu huwa al-ghafuru rahim. الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله عباد الله قال تعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. Dear Muslims, we all miss the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, but he is with us. It is our choice to get him out of our life or to be with him every moment we walk, we say what he said. Every moment we eat, we say what he told us to say, and when we finish eating, he never left us alone without giving us a teaching from him and a wisdom from him, so we never be alone if we follow the sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And with Anas bin Malik missing him, we can say, Bintum wa binna famartallat jawanihuna shawqan ilaykum wa ma jaffat ma'aqina. In kana fi dunya azza liqa'u bikum fa fi mawaqif al-hashri nalqaukum wa yakhfina. If we could not meet in this dunya, we have a hope. One day we will. And that is the day when we will get again together. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam will be looking for us, and how he will know us through what? Through the wudu and the serious salat you pray every day. He will recognize us with that. And he told us, Inna ummati yud'auna yawm al-qiyamati ghurran muhajjalina min athar al-wudu. Faman istata'a minkum an yutila ghurratahu falyaf'al. Take very seriously when you are making the wudu. It will be nur for you, and he will recognize his ummah among all the other nations with that. So perform your wudu right, and inshallah we will meet him. And Umar bin Khattab used to remind Sa'd bin Abi Waqas, Ya Sa'd, la yaghurrannaka qawlun nasi innaka khalu rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inna Allah azza wa jal laysa baynahu wa bayna ahadin min khalqihi nasab. O Sa'd, do not be in illusion or proud with this sentence to you when the Prophet said to you, you are my uncle. Remember that the only relation between Allah and anybody else from whom he is created is the taqwa, nothing else. So remember that and go to Allah with the taqwa, with the nasab. Don't say, I'm linked to the Prophet family. My father is a wali. My father is this and that. Whatever they have done, it is for them, and you only, you will save yourself. The way he said to his own daughter Fatima, Ya Fatima tu salini min mali ma shi'ti. La amliku laki min Allahi shay'a. Ask me from my wealth whatever you want. I will give it to you as a father. But in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that will never help you unless you follow the teaching of Islam. Allahumma aghfir lil muslimina wal muslimat wal mu'minina wal mu'minat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون احسنه اللهم احسن ختامنا واخرجنا من الدنيا مسلمين لا اله الا انت سبحانك انا كنا من الظالمين عباد الله ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون واقم الصلاه